Hello, my name is Yasmine Day, famous 1980s power ballad singer, most commonly known for fronting the Bonnie Tyler tribute act, the Yasmine Day Experience, and I'm absolutely delighted to be hosting the final event of the online Prague Fringe Festival, which is our open mic night. Applause. And open mic nights are so much fun, and haven't we got a night in store for you. Is that right, English? I'm not sure. So, basically, what we've got is a whole range of acts, and hopefully a lot of these people will be coming, or a lot of these performers will be coming to the Prague Fringe in October, so you might see some videos for some shows promoting their show for October, and we'll see a mixture of other performers as well, some sketches, some all sorts of things, what we've basically seen this week, but shorter. Bite-sized, really. But first, we have a proper introduction from the wonderful general manager of the Prague Fringe, Rosie.
Welcome to the last night of the first ever Prague Fringe online festival. My name's Rosie Dwelly, and I'm the general manager of the Prague Fringe Festival. Instead of letting our original festival dates slip quietly by, we decided to plan 9 full days of online entertainment for you to celebrate our festival in all its glory. We're here to celebrate our artists, our venues, our team members, our audiences from all over the world, and our very special friends. As well as all that, we've been raising money for our Prague Fringe Survival Fund, which we hope will help to secure the future of the festival, support artists who are coming in October if we're able to have a festival then, and to help make sure that the festival can continue into 2021, our 20th year. We'd like to say a huge thank you to all of the artists who've taken part in the festival, and particularly to Yasmine Day, our wonderful host, who's been seeing us through every day with her amazing live streams, and for hosting tonight's open mic night, a tradition that we usually start the festival with. So without further ado, I'm delighted to introduce our first video this evening from the wonderful Rendered Retina, Prague Fringe regulars and favourites. They've got a sing-along version of the opening song to last year's hilarious show, Timon of Athens. Enjoy.
The car. characters that will be making an appearance today, but just in case you didn't quite catch it the first time, we're going to go for it again. But we're going to play this time. Timon, Asmides, Tobias, Acamantus, Flavius, Similius, Lucilius, Lucilus, Lucius, Capis, Painter, Messenger, Orphelion, Lord 1, 2, 3, and Senators 1 and 2. So they're all the characters for a second time.
Front of house manager at Prague Fringe. I'm really glad we can bring you some of this festival online because it's such a special little festival. We do ask that if you can and if you're enjoying the content we're bringing you, that you help keep the festival alive by donating to the Prague Fringe Survival Fund, the link to which you can find all over our social media. So without further ado, I'm going to introduce to you an original sketch by Ben Goldsmith and Katie Davison. They will be bringing Steve's Last Day to Prague Fringe, and the sketch that you are about to see is Werther's original gangster. Enjoy.
Are we ready?
Ready, yeah.
Ever since the lockdown, we've seen that there's a lot of these how-to videos on YouTube. And our grandchildren have taught us how to use the camera, haven't they?
Yeah.
So we thought we'd make our own. Sorry, that's my telephone ringing. Dear. Stephen, if you're not calling to tell me that Sunglasses Ron is not breathing anymore, I will have your eyes. Do you understand? Good boy, thank you. I'm sorry about
it's
that,
okay,
dear.
It's okay.
So, we decided to make our own video. How to run a drugs cartel.
Clive, love.
Aye. Oh. We're filming the first bit of the video.
Aye.
Well, let me just get rid of these and we can get going.
Clive, is that a new Ovaltine?
Oh, we've got one open. So the first thing you need to know is who's going to be in your team when you're starting up a drugs cartel. And that's very easy. There's four positions. There's your Falcons, who essentially do the work on the streets, drop off the drugs, pick up the money. And then there's the hitmen, which is self-explanatory. And there's lieutenants, or lieutenants as we say in England. We're not in America now. And they essentially run the day-to-day business of the drugs cartel. And then, of course, there's drug lords, which in this situation is me and Irene.
It's us.
We've actually got a few of our people to send in little home videos to explain to you exactly what their job looks like.
Hello, Clive and Irene. I'm happy to tell you a little bit about what I do. I am a falcon, of course, so I give drugs to people that you sell them to, and I pick up the money and then redeposit it back to you, and I get a cut. It's a fantastic way to spend some time, and certainly better than what other people of my age are doing, bagging shopping in Sainsbury's and such like. I prefer Fortnum's, of course. I do have another part-time occupation, but this is a perfect supplement to it. The other one is that I'm a Viscount in several parts of Suffolk, so I sit in the House of Lords once a week. Lovely sandwiches.
Hello, Clive and Irene. My job is a hitman, or hit lady, if you will. So what that means is that I have to go in and unfortunately kill anyone who is mucking about. You know, back in my day, I would have used a knife, you know, good, quiet, honest, clean kill. But anyway, Clive and Irene, in their infinite wisdom, have given me a gun and a silencer. You know, there's a gadget for everything these days. It is quick, but it's not as honest. Right, pass me the hand mangler.
Hello, Clive and Irene. I'm, of course, a lieutenant in your little company, and I'm going to tell you about what I do. But first off, you'll never guess who I saw earlier on. It was Jiminy the Cricket from Ipswich. He was in town disposing of someone from that lot over the other side of the park. We had a laugh. We went for a coffee in, what's that place? What's it called? Goodness me, names escapes me. McDonald's, that's the one. Goodness me, do you know that they do little ice creams now? We had two each. Anyway, what was I saying? Have you heard about Kenny? Kenny the Clipper? He got ashamed off his eyebrows, looks surprised all the time. I remember once in 1956 I went down to Lord's, cricket's bollocks, go and see some dog fighting. Oh, he had a laugh. What's it called? Yeah. Prison, we did. Went to the prison with each other. Never guess who I saw there. Princess Anne. Keith Chegwin. But anyway, what I do is essentially manage some people.
I need to tell you all the other things you need to be a drugs cartel. First off, you need a producer. Because, as everybody knows, you ain't got any drugs to sell. You're not a cartel. That's why we have the rhyme, you see. And actually, I think our Clive's just on the phone to our producer right now.
Barry? Hello, Barry. Do you have some of the organic stuff? That's fantastic. Please do put that in the wicker basket as well. And John the Bastard will be round with the payment. He'll pop it in on Tuesday. And I hear you've been dealing with the Southend boys. You know what I'm going to say, don't you? If I catch you doing that again, I'm going to have your eyes. Thanks very much. Oh! Is that you with that camera again?
Yeah.
You are becoming a regular Steven Spielberg, aren't you?
Of course, the next thing you need as a drugs cartel is arms.
Weapons.
Weapons. Killing machines. So, luckily for us, we have a local chemist where we pick up our arms. It's fantastic. You can just pop by, pick up your synatogens, your prune juice, your ammo, a Glock, you know, all in one place.
Prune juice gives me plenty of ammo, if you know what I mean. Eh?
Oh.
You get it? Yeah. Eh? Booze.
Clive.
It's good.
He is very regular.
The last thing we need to tell you about is money laundering. And look, we don't touch that at all. The things that the tax man would be interested in, we don't do it.
Never.
But we do have another business just down the road, a little tea shop, don't we?
We do.
Lovely place.
Oh, lovely.
And remind me, Irene, how much revenue did the tea shop do last month?
£18 million.
£18 million, and how many teas did we sell?
Two.
At a cost of £9 million per tea, if you catch me drift.
It's money laundering.
Don't. No, you can't. We can't tell him that it's money laundering.
Sorry, I wasn't sure. I've just put the video on the computer and I realised I forgot the most important piece of information, which, of course, is never get high on your own supply. Oh, Clive.
Gardner's world has never been the same since Alan Titchmarsh left.
Oh, brilliant. Right, it's going to be like this all afternoon.
Haven't we had a wonderful time so far? You know, it's been so wonderful, I've had to have a lie down. It's too much for me. I get too emotional when I see art. It's just, I love it. You know, I love it. Now, next up, we have a shout out from Ty Autry. Now, he has done two events in this week's Prague Fringe. So he's a familiar face. He's basically, well, he's a celebrity like me, sort of like, not as famous as me, but he is a celebrity, you know, in his own special way. And so I'm very, very excited about that. He's absolutely wonderful and lovely. Poem from Kat Hepburn from her show Girlhood, and it's called Flawless. Maybe it's dedicated to me, who knows? You know, I love poetry. I feel like it's a lot like songs, you know, poems. Sometimes I sing poems, you know, poems that I make up. You know, there once was a cat who sat on a mat, who then had a friend called Rat. And that's a song. There once was a cat who sat on a mat, who then had a friend called Rat. That was from my 10th album, You Know It Until You Show It. That was what it was called. Wonderful, wonderful. It didn't chart, but they play it sometimes at London Zoo. Coming up next, we have these two fantastic acts.
Hey everybody, it's Ty Autry from the United States. I just want to give a quick shout out to Prague Fringe for allowing us to come together on this virtual Fringe as we wait for October to roll around. I had the honor of showcasing an older version of my solo show, A Southern Fairy Tale, and also got to teach a wonderful webinar on branding that was filled with some incredible people and that shared their stories. I hope to see you all in October and can't wait to share more stories and listen to everything that y'all have to share with me.
What do women need to feel beautiful? Just be yourselves, right? With big doe eyes, silky thick tresses from Brazilian blow dries. Cheekbones, if not there by nature, draw them on high. Perfect peachy skin and a face with no pores or lines. You'll need a big booty and a tiny waist with curvaceous hips, inflated and swollen, kissable lips. Up here, not down there, that's just not right. And breasts are best when they're the exact same size. Painful intimate waxes are par for the course, as are shaved legs and underarms and HD brows and heavy lashes. And girls, you better do something about those tashes. Love Island copycats are lauded as goddesses. Hair extensions, mahogany fake tan, thigh gaps and abs. You need a beach ready body for likes on Instagram. Did you know that bleaching your bumhole is a thing? Have you tried Botox or microneedling? Fillers, slicing skin, chemical peels, far too thin from skipping meals, or weight loss lollipops, or detox tea, or just plain laxatives, though watch out for wee accidents. Are you on the endless search for unattainable beauty? Well, join the club. Hen, get yourself some cellulite scrub. Put simply, it's all about conformity and perfect symmetry achieved so easily with liposuction or silicone. A wee bit of re-sculpting and breaking of your bones, sucking and nipping and tucking in that tum. How about some big bouncy implants for your bum? Goodbye crooked tooth, hello blinding white veneers. So we fetishise youth, nothing wrong with winding back the years because our value goes down with the passing of time. It pisses people off if we're too old, too big, too small, or let's face it, the fact that we exist at all. But don't worry, there's always Photoshop.
Hi, I'm Megan. I've been doing the Prague Fringe since 2014 when I saw a special day at Studio Rubin. And since 2017, I've been doing the Prague Fringe Marathon Reviews for the Prague Youth Theatre blog. And the next act we have for you at this open mic is a trailer for Sarah Stearnes' new play, Navigate, about a shipwrecked figurehead that comes to life and sails off the edge of the world into outer space. And a woman moves to a new country and can't even figure out how to brew a proper cup of coffee. We hope to see her in October.
Farewell and adieu to you, Spanish lady. Farewell and adieu to you, ladies of Spain. For we received orders for to sail to old England. But we hope very soon we will see you again.
Hi, I'm Ellen.
And I'm Lois, and we're coming at you from the Hollywood Fringe. We just wanted to send all of our love and support.
Our Fringe fam across the globe. Your aces, Prague Fringe!
We love you!
Happy Prague Fringe!
Corona, Corona, if only it stayed distant from us, totally socially distanced from us, we'd not have the fuss of shutting down all of theatre. Corona, Corona, if only it had been a little less rampant, a little more distant, or us more resistant, we'd be less insistent on moving online all of theatre. Corona, Corona, if only I'd shown you my show, you'd then know how wonderful, joyful, playful it is to let this show biz happen inside of a theatre. But here we are, outside the theatre, wondering where we are, when we'll be back. Here we are, inside our living room, living on only Zoom and online chat. But here you are, watching us being here, grappling with being here behind a screen. And here you are giving us strength to be trying things differently behind a screen. Corona, Corona, you thought you could mute us, but microphones on. We'll carry on whilst staying at home. We'll never be gone. The show must go on out of the theatre. Corona, Corona, you might be a nuisance, but this is endurance, a public assurance. We'll see perseverance. Prague and the world care for theatre. And cos we care for the theatre, we'll all be there in October. And cos you care for what we show, we all know it's not over.
The next video is from Sky All the Bird, who are going to bring their show Travelling Through Life to Prague Fringe. Here's the video that they've sent us for this online celebration called Moving On.
Hello, my name is Dan. People often ask if I'm desperate. My answer is always the same, yes. I have to find a place to stash all this money, and under the bed is not an option. I move on a lot. When I say move on, I mean run away. I'm always running away. I'm like Frankenstein's monster. The good people turn up with the brands and pitchforks and I'm gone, made my exit scarpered and quit the scene. I don't currently have a bed. I had a bed once, which I shared with a woman. She was good, I mean a real woman. I shared her, yeah, I shared her. I shared her with my friends. And always when it really mattered, she and I were in each other's arms. It's what we agreed. These things can trouble certain people. You know the kind, swan people. Those who mate for life. Constant, true, monogamous.
Never fall in love.
I've never been one of those. I think by design I wasn't made that way, so don't hold it against me. Anyway, once upon a time, I acquired some money. How? You want to know how?
I didn't think you'd ask.
I had a woman in a bed. If you can't make money once you have those, you have no place at the table, round or otherwise. I was no knight, but I had some paper.
Get the money. Where's it coming from?
I had some pelf and I loaned it for my own interest. Sometimes to friends and sometimes to foes. It wasn't my friends who let me down, though I lost them all. It was greed that drew down Valhalla. They were going to take my balls. I got out. But the times I were living through had no constant because the woman left. As soon as the debts got sour. So I had to find a way to live on my wits. Now, if you're looking at me thinking I'm a witless creature, ask yourself, could I stand before you if I did not know what I was doing? No, I could not. So think kindly and take pity on a pilgrim. Living on nothing but your wits is like being a real grown-up. It's all your fault if you fuck it up and you can't hide. So I decided to keep moving forward. Only now I'm dying and I wish to go back.
Be cursed.
I rode into town on the proverbial golden carriage. What did I need? Food, bed and beer. What did I have? The gift of the gab. Do you believe? I mean, you're listening. If I'm lying, I'm dying. Tell me, based on what we know, you'd buy me a pint, wouldn't you? Well, it went like that. I selected women, didn't I? Yes, surely I did, because we've all, haven't we, leant on a woman in our lives, either romantically or for upright moral support. Presented myself as a man of possibilities, in need of a good dose of saving. And let me tell you most sincerely, it works. Women invest in men, time and time again.
You invested?
It started with investing a bit of knowledge, and it will end with investing a bit of knowledge. They just didn't realize I was only dropping the eaves because I'm a common thief. You don't understand my words, but it's true. Too true. So then came the one who killed me. I'd done my usual routine. Only this time, this woman, I was a fool for.
Never fall in love, never fall in love, never fall in love.
Let's ask ourselves how old we are. Nobody over the age of 30 wants to hear about masturbation, and nobody over the age of 40 wants to consider true love. I'm talking about the kind of love that doesn't own up to being in the world. The things you accrue, the letdowns, the breakups, the unconscionable fantasies that have done more harm in the real world than they ever did in your head. I'm talking about falling for a woman like I'm not a criminal. That's criminal.
Never fall in love, never fall in love, never fall in love, never fall, never fall.
You wanna know how she did it? She drove me to the circus with her kid in the back.
Fall in love, never fall in love, never fall in love, never fall, never fall in love, never fall, never fall in love.
Now I have ethics. You might not believe, but I do. One of them's never to grift the woman with children. But you see, I didn't know she was a mother before I'd made my promise. I was invested, over-invested. So when the kid turned up, I started fooling myself, I could make this work. Anyway, we wanted to go to the circus. We joked about being with our own kind for the kid. Kid had never been to the circus. She gets out of the car. What you have to understand about this woman is she's not shy. She demanded attention I was happy to give. Anyway, she wanders over to a roustabout.
Don't. No, you.
Circus is started. Too bad, you've missed it. Now, I know this guy's gonna see her hanging in the window by the pound, and I can't do a thing about it. Got my eyes on the kid. Anyway, the roustabout and my woman have an exchange. Then she says, "Now look at my ass," and turns around and walks away. See, the problem is, in my game, you have to know what people are saying and you have to know what they're thinking. And as she walks back in her very tight trousers, I'm pretty sure, I mean certain, that the roustabout says, "Ooh, you're an asshole," in about as lascivious a way as would incense.
You asshole.
Now, usually I would let this slide, but you see, I'm into this woman and I think I've become a knight in spite of myself, so decide to protect her honour. She gets in the car, I run towards the roustabout, I swing for him, I catch him on the temple. It's a million to one hit, I'm Mike Tyson, he does not get back up. I turn around and walk to the car, she's absorbed in her charm. Says, "What are you up to?" I said, "Oh, I just wanted to catch a glimpse of one of those caravans, I've always wanted a caravan." And we drive off. The next day, I'm reading in the papers about the roustabout's death.
It's payday.
I'm scared. You don't fuck with these people. They will always, always find a way to destroy you. They've existed in the shadow of genocide for centuries, and they keep going. They just keep on keeping on. And I turn the page, and there's a picture of his wife. She's put a curse on the assailant.
Be cursed.
For days I tell myself, I'm not credulous to this. I can't believe, I won't believe, but I know. I mean, deep down, I know. I know as certain as the cancer that's taken hold of my lungs that this curse is turning me blacker than night on the inside. It is the curse I earned for falling in love in a way I said I would never. So what am I doing? Going back to my hometown to die. I have always said where there's a debt to pay, there's a reason to go back, and the biggest debt I have is to my hometown. There is a bench next to a fountain near a river, and that is where I want to die. The cost to return is £10.10. It isn't much to ask, and I don't have it. So, sir, madam, young lady, would you spare some change for a man who was fucked when he tried? I'm moving on. Send me on my way.
Hello, me again. I'm just leaning against the wall, just thinking about love, as you normally do. Is everybody having a lovely time? I'm having an absolutely wonderful time. Now, next up, we have a couple of very exciting things. First, or I don't know if it's first, but it's going to be one of my music videos from my next hit, Why Won't They Let Me Back? Now, it's a topic very close to my heart, and it makes me so sad to think about it, but you know those things when you just, everybody's had their heart broken, and that this song really does encapsulate that. So it's my new music video, which is fantastic. My roommate, she actually filmed it for me, and she's a lovely woman, but you know, she's not got the best filming technique. She's got quite a shaky hand, but you know, we managed to pull through. So I hope you really enjoy it. And also, we have a sing-along from Rendered Retina's theatre show, Timon of Athens. I hope I got that right. But please, also, before we see all of these wonderful acts, don't forget to donate to the Prague Fringe Festival online. We've raised lots of our target, but we would love to raise some more. Think about it as if you were buying me a drink, you know, at a bar, or buying my CD or mini disc, you know. Think of it like that. And it's really, really going to a great cause. Anyway, stay tuned and enjoy the next few acts.
That was Cyndi Lauper with True Colours. Now another 80s diva, Yasmine Day. This songstress was a one-hit wonder back in 1986 with Love Hurts When Eagles Fly. And she's back with a new single about love and loss.
Why won't they let me back on loose women? I've begged and pleaded time and time again. Last time I was on the show, I did my best. And other than that one thing, was a really great guest. That video of me went viral, you know. And whatever the producers say, it didn't ruin the show. Why won't they let me back on loose women? Why won't they let me back on loose women? I remember that summer's day so clearly. Nervous in the green room, I got a little tipsy. When I went on, I shouted, "Here I f***ing am." Then crawled into the audience and met all of my fans. Colleen Nolan screamed at me to come sit down.
What a bitch.
And 20 minutes later, I eventually calmed down. Why won't they let me back on loose women? Why won't they let me back on loose women? We chatted about so many great topics. Like, would you smack your children or do you have enough sex? And I said, well, I know who I'd like to smack. And looked at Jane McDonald as she stared right back. To break the awkward silence, I started to sing my brand new Christmas hit, Let the Bells Ding. I yelled, who cares if it's June? Let's liven up this shit show. But Jane McDonald stood up and told me I had to go. And I slurred, you never wanted me to succeed. When we did diamond cruises together, you were always jealous of me. You want me off this show, but I shan't. You stupid cunt. Why won't they let me back on loose women? Why won't they let me back on loose women? Give me an another go. You see, I've got a song to promote. It's called Why Won't They Let Me Back on Loose Women?
Lords 1, 2, and 3. So go and tell everyone you know.
It's tonight.
Yes, tonight.
What's tonight?
Oh, the feast.
That's tonight.
Yes, that's right. Go and tell everyone to go.
To the what? To the feast.
Tell me where.
Down the street.
I'll go now.
Grab a seat.
Cause it's a feast. Feast for the Kath is well, ooh, it amazes. Time to get her table set, because it is not ready yet. Anything we need, he will pay. Lobster, fish and caviar, the guests will all say, ooh, ah, and he'll serve it upon a silver tray. My friends are here. Hello.
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 Help yourself to the canapes. Here they are. They've all appeared. Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Pour yourself a glass of the champagne. It's a feast. Feast for the ages. Look at my wealth.
Rachel, the younger of the Sweeney sisters. I've been a member of the Prague Front of House team for the past 4 years, and during quarantine me and my sister thought that it would be fun to reminisce on the various wonderful venues that Prague Fringe has, and the fun bits and sometimes more challenging bits of working at each venue, and make this little TikTok sketch for you guys. I can't wait to see everyone back in October and visit all these venues again, so enjoy!
What do you mean it's change time?
No, you can't. You can't open the window.
You can't eat that in here. Sorry. You can just go right outside though, that's fine, but you can't eat that in here. Sorry.
They haven't landed. Their show's in an hour.
Oh, the you can take one if you like. I think you're allowed to just read them.
You give us these. Can't open the window. I'm too warm too. You can't open the windows. They brought a different show.
Oh, watch the stairs.
Do you speak French?
Oh, there's a bar downstairs, if you like. Yeah. Shitting hell, it's a car.
Action. They brought a different show.
No!
Hello, I'm Ali, Operations Manager for Prague Fringe. For Fringe in real life, my job is to work with the wonderful festival assistants to make sure that audiences and artists have the best time. But here, for hashtag Prague Fringe Online, it's my job to introduce to you a Prague Fringe regular, Twonkey. Old habits die hard, so may I ask you to turn your mobile phones to silent, and may I remind you that smoking and use of cameras is not permitted during the performance. If you enjoy the show today, please tell a friend. Now, put your hands together and get ready to take a sneak peek at Twonkey's latest show, Twonkey's Custard Club.
The actors come from Belarus and some they came from Turkey. We all want world peace and so does Bert and Gertie. I follow it around with my eyes. I follow it around with my spoon. The wind falls me in, the taxi for the bin. Bing, bang, bing, crash, things go bing. When the custard stops flowing, it is time to be going. When the custard stops flowing, it is time to be going. It is time, I am going. What the train master tells you to do.
Hello, my name is Cameron Abbott-Betts and I'm the co-director of the Colchester Fringe Festival here in sunny Essex in the UK. I'm also an ex-Prague Fringe Festival assistant, so on a personal level, I just want to send my love to everyone in Prague and I have everything crossed that you'll be able to proceed with your Fringe in October. But until then, I would like you to enjoy a snippet of the bubble show by the Highland Joker. It's a unique blend of magic, storytelling and bubble art. There is every type of bubble you can imagine from this Guinness World Record holder. I hope you enjoy.
My name is Around the Bubble Man, also known as the Highland Joker, and I am a bubble artist. Many years ago, I used to serve in the army, but then I went traveling around the world, and one day I came across giant soap bubbles. I noticed how much joy, happiness, and peace they bring to people. I wanted to do that in the world, to bring joy to others through this medium of bubbles. And so today I make bubbles for a living. It's amazing seeing how people react with amazement and laughter. Kids always like chasing the bubbles. These spheres of water and soap and air are so simple, yet so magical and profound. So I stopped carrying a gun in the name of war and replaced it with a bubble wand. So now I blow bubbles for peace. I travel the world performing with my bubbles in the streets of cities and towns and villages. As a professional actor, I also wanted to develop and produce an indoor bubble show designed for a theatre space. And so the Highland Joker Bubble Show was born. It is a blend of storytelling, magic, a bit of science, a bit of clowning, and a lot of soap bubbles. I make smoke bubbles, fire bubbles, cube bubbles, giant bubbles, and putting people inside a bubble as we journey together through the realms of Bubble Land. My main aim with the show is really to inspire young people to follow their dreams. Follow their bubbles as they journey through life, so they too can soar high in the sky.
Hi, I'm Andrea. I'm the press relations and social media manager for Prague Fringe. Next up for the open mic tonight, we have the trailer for Best Served Gold by Acting Out. This is Acting Out's second visit to the festival. Last year, their show, The Decriminalization Monologues, was nominated for our Inspiration Award. So enjoy this short sample from a new comedy about friendship and relationships.
From the Richmond Fringe Festival. My name is Carmel, I'm the directrix, and I'm really sad I can't be in Prague this year for Fringe. But I cannot wait to see what you've got going for the future. Long live Fringe. Long may she sparkle.
Oh, isn't that wonderful? We have had shout outs from all fringes all across the world, and it's great, there's more places for me to tour. You know, I've got to take my act everywhere. I am an international artist after all. Now, as you can see, I'm in my shower. I love just standing in the shower for a bit of me time. You know, I just sit and I just think about love. It's wonderful, it really is. Now, next up, we have a piece of comedy by Rebecka Vilhonen, and it's called Such a Shame, which is what a reviewer from Melody Maker called my top 200 hit, Love Hurts When Eagles Fly. Enjoy.
I don't know what that was. Hello, my name is Rebecka and I'm coming to Prague Fringe in October with my stand-up show, Such a Shame. Please come and watch me perform and hopefully I'll make you laugh. Bye.
So my name is Meghana. I'm from the city of Bombay or Mumbai in India. Earlier this year, I found out about a brand new mental disorder. And because I'm very cool and hip, I already have it. It's called climate grief, sometimes also referred to as ecological grief or climate anxiety. In case you're wondering if you have it, I'll tell you the symptoms. Sadness, fear, anger, frustration, helplessness, a sense of loss and mourning in the face of finding out about the destruction of the environment. And it's really fun to have this disorder. And I speak from personal experience because it's incurable. And every time you try to make it better, you just feel worse. For example, I have climate grief. I'm a survivor of climate grief. And I said I want to do something to help it, and the only thing I can do to help it is to help the environment, to feel like I'm contributing. So I reuse, reduce, recycle. We compost in my house in Bombay every piece of organic matter that enters our house. I have taken only 10 Ubers this year, of them 4 were to and from the airport. I take the tram, metro, bus, you know, I do everything possible. So you do all of these things and you're exhausted because it takes a lot of work to try to save the environment. And one day you're tired and you realize that nothing you do matters. Because the only thing that will save the environment environment is changing the system of consumerism and capitalism and Jeff Bezos destroying the environment, and that's not going to happen. So you think, you know what, today I'm exhausted, I'm not feeling well, I've done a lot for the environment, so I'm going to allow myself to take an Uber. It's okay, I'm not destroying the earth. So you book the Uber, and you sit down and you think, ah, oh, I'm so comfortable. And then you cry the rest of the way home because you're a horrible person who's destroying the earth, you piece of shit. Anyway, it's fun. So I have to repeatedly tell myself, don't panic. First slide of my presentation. As you can see, a lot of research went into that. So I'm from Bombay, like I mentioned, and living in Bombay makes your climate grief much worse because Bombay, the city, is on the sea. Now, in English, when you say on the sea, you usually mean on the coast, but I mean literally on the sea. Because I'm a selfish person, I read about forest fires and I feel worried. But I read about ice melting and I shit in my pants because this is what my city used to look like. So I continued doing research and I said, you know, maybe you're wrong. Let's find out how much Mumbai might flood. And I found this website called climatecentral.org and I recommend it to all of you. It's a free resource. They highly encourage you to go and check it out. All you do is you type the name of any coastal region in the world and they will tell you how much it's going to flood. And you can pick all these standards, right? So like depending on if we do extreme carbon cuts, moderate carbon cuts or no carbon cuts. If temperature rises 2 degrees, 4 degrees, 6 degrees. If we have very good luck, medium luck or amazing luck. So I went and I put all the worst indicators and I went to Mumbai in 2050. So all the red things, can everybody see? Yeah? So all the red bits are gonna be sea. And that's quite a scary image. But my house isn't red, so I don't give a shit. Now I have a question for you guys. Have any of you ever thought that maybe climate scientists are wrong or lying? Even if you thought it for half a second. And I don't mean like Donald Trump climate denier bullshit people. Who has ever thought this? Even if you felt guilty, even if you erased it from your mind immediately. Yes. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4.5. Okay, so we have 4.5 plus me intelligent people in the audience. And everybody else is very, very sweet and innocent. And also wrong. Huh?
For me, the opposite makes more sense. Sorry.
Climate scientists are wrong as fuck. And I have proof.
Good morrow, dear citizen. It's me, Prince Henry from Happily Ever Pufter. I hope you're all enjoying the open mic day today. I don't know who Mike is or why he's open or what's open. He should be staying at home. But I hope you're enjoying the celebrations nonetheless. This is all part of Prague Fringe Online's festival. We can't be together this year for Prague Fringe Festival, but we're bringing you entertainment and joy nonetheless. Speaking of, if you would like to come and join me for Happily Ever Pufter Live this evening, Saturday, then do come along to Facebook Live, where Happily Ever Pufter will be giving you a live offering of our little show. You can find it on Prague Fringe's Facebook page, and I look forward to seeing you there. Whatever you're doing during this lockdown moment, please stay well, stay safe, and enjoy the open mic event. Take care.
Hi, I'm Becca. I'm the front of house manager with Prague Fringe, and this year would be my 7th year out in Prague with the team. I can't wait to get back out there in October and to bring the full programme of shows to you guys then. Up next, we have the final song from Time in of Athens, questioning the pronunciation, which is one of our shows last year. It was a brilliant, brilliant show. So enjoy what the boys have for you.
Time ran away, could not bear to stay. Gave all that he gave, but was not repaid. So he ran away, he ran night and day, scaled a big mountain, stumbled on a cave. 'Twas a massive cave, next to a forest. He had no money, time of a fame.
My name's Ellen and I am Venue Branding and Print Distribution Manager at Prague Fringe, which means that in a normal festival I look after all of the posters and the decorating of the venues and the flyering on behalf of the artists. For this digital festival I have been the producer and the woman behind the scenes doing all the tech for all the events and I've also helped pull together today's open mic, and I just wanted to say thank you to everyone who's been a part of it, who's bought a virtual drink at our virtual survival bar. Please buy me a beer now if you fancy, but for everyone who's donated and donated their time to be a part of this digital festival, thank you so, so much. We're so glad to still be shouting about the wonderful Fringe Festival that Prague is. It's my great pleasure to introduce our next video, which is the second of Kat Hepburn's poems from her show Girlhood. This one's called Chemicals. Enjoy.
We meet on a works night out. Picture the scene. Pleather karaoke booths, a free bar, avoiding eye contact with Jill from HR, an untouched buffet of beige farm foods, fried finger foods. Did I mention the free bar? And the dimly lit room is filled with about 20 millennials who hate working at that call centre almost as much as they love getting on it. A wobbly Chesney Hawks rendition is unashamedly belted out by Gaz from accounts. And with just one look, me and my relatively handsome workmate escape. And the booze floods through our bloodstream as we talk about everything. Caught up in a whirlwind, shot with an arrow by a cock-eyed cupid. He is just the tonic for me. The alchemy of it all makes me giddy. Guard was up to begin with, but with him it's melted away pretty quickly. See, to be honest, I am defenceless to his charms. Disarmed by bevy-laden banter, patter delivered to me by a supreme enchanter. We meet up the very next day. It's a far too summery Saturday in May and Glasgow is absolutely cooking. We get steaming in an overcrowded beer garden. He says we're lucky to get a spot. I just feel lucky that I'm with him. We are the bubbles in tenants' tops and ethanolic whiskey chasers on the rocks, and on the sly, I text my best pal Kim. OMG, I think I love him. Heart emoji, heart emoji. And we're swept up. A sunset drives us to a friendly dispute in an old man's pub. The usual clientele roll their eyes at the snort and my laugh, but I don't care. And we end up at the dancing that night, and in the smoking area our skin is pink and freckled from the unanticipated sun, and back inside over the music I shout, This is so much fun. I know, I'm a fanny. And then the perfect storm of dopamine, nicotine, oxytocin, serotonin, whatever the hell we got that messed us up so much. I'm romanced by his quick-witted chat outside that crappy nightclub and then back at the after-party at that lassie's flat where we played Twister and FaceTimed his wee sister, and he is full of philosophy and academic musings, and we dance to unironic 90s R&B till the sun comes up, and falling in love is some buzz.
Hi, I am Aneshka, and I'm the campaign manager at the Prague Fringe Festival, for which I've been working for 5 years now. The next video is brought to you by Rebecka, Pershagen and the Swan Woman. Enjoy!
Thank you.
morning, good afternoon and good evening to you all, wherever you're listening from. Thank you very much for taking part in this, what has been quite possibly the most unusual week in the 19-year history of the Prague Fringe. It's been heartbreaking every day to come down here and to not personally see you all, hug you, welcome you to Prague, welcome you back to Prague, watch your fantastic performances, and then have a drink in the bar at the end of the day. It's been the weirdest feeling. And of course, that feeling extends right around the globe to all of us who should have been here this week. What would have been our 19th Prague Fringe. But we held our heads up high. We did it. We got through it. We've had a fantastic programme of events online. Lots of things that we wouldn't have actually had under normal circumstances. So that's actually quite an interesting thing. And of course, we're now exploring the possibilities of doing more of that in the future. We've had really interesting talks. We've had quizzes. We've had theatre performances. We've had walks, guided walks around Prague even. Who knew? It has been unusual, but it has been fantastic. And I can't thank you all enough for tuning in. I'd like to thank all of our sponsors, especially Avast, our main partner. This has just been like the fifth year of collaborating with you. It's taken the festival to a whole new level. Really special thanks to our dear, dear friends, Jenny and Alan, who've been watching from Vermont. Another thanks to a really special couple, Karen and Richard York, who've been watching down in Luxembourg, and to all of our sponsors and all of our media partners who have made this online festival happen this week. I'd also like to thank all the staff who've been amazing. They've pulled this all together in like minutes, it seems. We really didn't start working on this till about 2 weeks ago. We were resisting the idea of having an online festival. So a massive thanks to Rosie, of course, and Alana, to Emma and Andrea, who have done all of our social media single-handedly. We haven't seen you all week, but you've been working in your own places. A mega, mega thanks to Ellen, who came on board also quite late. She worked with us at the festival last year, and she's produced this entire week of online activities. It's been really overwhelming and fantastic. I'm pretty sure I've thanked everyone. I'll get a row if I've missed anybody out. Of course, yes, the people who have donated to our fund. We are trying to survive till next year's festival. We still don't know, of course, if October is going to go ahead or not. We are planning that it will go ahead. In the eventuality that it does go ahead, a lot of the money that we've raised this week will go towards helping the artists who have struggled all year round without any work to make sure that they get to the festival. And if October doesn't happen, the money that we've raised will take us through into the next festival. Hopefully things will be more normal by then. So I'm pretty sure that's it. I think I've thanked everyone. I don't think I've missed anyone out. But the donations and the amount of money we've raised in the last, what is it now, seven days up to today, has been fantastic. So thank you very much for that. There's still time to donate. If you want to donate more, feel free to. We're not shy. And finally, if you wonder why I'm in such a weird location, what is going on? Well, all is about to be revealed. I shall turn the camera around, if that is even possible. How do we turn it around? I'll just have to turn... Oh, wait a minute. Hang on. Hang on a minute. How does it turn round? Don't know. I'll just turn it round and show you. Hopefully you'll see what's happening. I've come up a tower that I've never been up in my life before. I've always waited for the excuse to come up here, and today seemed the perfect day. It's a beautiful sunny day. This is the Malostranska Tower of the Charles Bridge. I'm tucked in a wee corner of the tower looking across. You can see quite a lot of the landmarks there. You see the back of Beseda. You can see the British Embassy, that creamy building with the little tower to the right. Big shout out for Jan Thompson, who was our ambassador patron for 4 years when she was here. Up at the castle there, you can see all the details of what's happening up there. I don't know why I'm just speaking now. Well, they've got some scaffolding up there. What's going on? That's what I was talking about. St. Nicholas Church and the back of Malostranska Nami. So you can just see the corner of the Inspiratsi building and, of course, the rooftops where Ruben takes place. I'll whirl around a wee bit. I hope this is working because I can't see a thing. And you can see a bit more of Malostrana there. But thanks again, everybody. This has been really weird, but really wonderful. And thanks to everybody for being part of it all. And let's just all meet again, not virtually, but really in October. Take care, look after each other, and sending huge hugs across the miles. I forgot to mention one really important thing. Please stay tuned for our very own fringe poet, Annie Moir. By the way, that's the tower I was up, right there, in case anybody was wondering. Have a great night.
The legacy of COVID-19 Prague Fringe Festival, May 2020, or Corona Alona at Homer with crap music. There's a southern fairy tale on Plague Radio, translating personalities with Cybus Shane Singo, as Yasmine launches a virtual stream of delights for Buddhist cats on form in Queer Quiz Nights. Love hurts when eagles fly, and London's own gay men's choir raise the roof to bravely bridge our troubled waters, happy ever after poofters. Men with coconuts rove with gold, meeting Jim at the decriminalisation lockdown built to contain improv within Prague's hushed town. Theatres, bars, all mute, silent faces follow suit. Dear festival family, audience, performers, directors, crew, before we forget to say it,
we love you.
Now that is what we call in the music business a wrap, which means it's over. You know, that means that this night is over. The Prague Online Festival is over, which I'm very sad about. You know, it's really made my week. So in order to say a goodbye properly, I'm going to sing a goodbye song, which I'm going to make up. I'm very good at improvising songs. Very good. It's a bit like jazz. Here we go. Goodbye, goodbye, until October. Goodbye, goodbye, I'll always look over my shoulder for everyone in Prague and everyone who's watching. I really hope that you've had a nice splotching. I'll probably be releasing that song next week. Let's hope that it gets to number one. I hope you've had a wonderful week and a wonderful time, and I will see you all very soon. Goodbye.